Hi, I'm Steve Charles. I spoke at the 2018 American Society of Cataract and Refractive Surgery about the need to do OCT before every cataract surgery, not just with premium IOLs. I coined the term visual surprises to make the case if you're absolutely dead on with your refractive outcomes that you predicted for the patient, with the patient, then the patient's expectations are met with regard to their refractive outcomes, but the vision is not perfect, the patients are very unhappy. There are many macular diseases that are simply invisible in clinical examination. We already have the problem of the cataract obscuring your view. We have the problem with the 90D diopter lens of the slit lamp is insufficient to see these diseases. So what are these diseases? Central serous retinopathy, we see more and more in 50-year-olds because of excessive use of systemic steroids and injectable steroids of various types, exacerbating central serous. Vitreomacular traction syndrome, vitreomacular ascesis, small wet AMD lesions with a modest amount of subretinal fluid and no hemorrhage. There are other examples, but in short, there are many diseases that with fundus examination, you will miss it. Optos is simply inadequate for macular screening, period, end of story. And then we have the problem of co-management and is the optometric community sufficiently trained to recognize all the macular diseases? Some of them very good, others might not catch what it is. And the cataract surgeons have so much to do to get the refractive outcomes right. Let's address this problem of visual surprises by getting an OCT. Now, OCT and OCT, they're different types. We must use either modern spectral domain OCT, such as the Heidelberg or the Zeiss or the Optavia or the new swept source OCT. And we must look at every single grayscale or black and white image ourselves. It takes 2 seconds to scan through them with your thumb on the thumb wheel of the mouse. Do not have a technician or photographer pick an image. Do not use color coding, 3D graphic or thickness maps. Everything that is thick is not edema. We have this misconception that epimacular membrane predisposes to macular edema, not true. We have this misconception that cataract surgery can make AMD or DME worse, also not true. Largely, this is because of interpreting everything as a thickness increase as edema, when in fact, all these disorders I just listed have nothing to do with edema, but in fact require management. Some of them should be managed before the cataract surgery, others after, but you must have that dialogue and have the dialogue with your retinal specialist. Thank you for listening. I hope you'll help our patients avoid this and yourselves avoid this problem of visual surprises.